Alright guys, welcome back to episode 2 of Hellblade. I mean, I've been enjoying this game so far, and I decided to continue our part 2 because yesterday I played like only on like 1 hour? Almost 1 hour, so today we continue our part 2. Let's go guys! Hellblade Senua, sacrifice. Kind of interesting game. One of the coolest thing about this game, like when you click the game, you don't have to save it. It's gonna be saved automatically. And oh god, I feel so creepy with the sound. Why it looks so red, bro? No, so what I am supposed to do? So we arrived here yesterday and the door is locked. There is another part. Maybe here? No. God. What? There's no clue here, guys. Ah. God. I didn't see this way first. Oh my god. Okay, so this is where he pointed.
Immerse was a frost giant. A being of darkness, and all his sons and grandsons were dark after him. Of his daughters and granddaughters, some were monstrous, but others fair. But there was another who came from the ice, Buri. In shape, he was like a man, big and powerful. His son, Bor, took a fair giant to be his wife, and they had 3 sons. Odin was the eldest.
Do you know what it's like to leave everything behind?
Your home, no.
Loved ones.
Oh my god. The creepy start coming back again?
Perhaps never to return.
I'm not sure if this is the creepy start is us or
Senua does.
No. Finally we make some progress, guys. We make some progress. It took me a while to find a way out.
And loved ones into strangers. Exile makes sense when you realize that you were never really home in the first place.
Okay. So, finally we here. God, look at that. This is the giant symbol. I mean, so big. So, in order to unleash our quest, we have to look at that. Yeah. Oh my god.
Oh
God, so many of them, and so many of that dude.
The song. Valravn. Valravn's song.
Follow him. Follow him. Follow the song.
It's over here. It's over here. Is that? It's
there. God.
No, it's here. There's two. Listen, focus. Listen.
One over there. And the other one over there.
This reminds me.
Which one should I go for?
Where?
No, which not this way.
Forest in the wilds. The wilds. She left the wilds. She went to the wilds a long time ago. Why did she go to the wilds? She wanted to fight her own darkness. She thought she could beat her own darkness. Did she beat her darkness? No. It nearly killed her, but she tried. Druth. Druth helped her. If it wasn't for Druth, she'd be dead. She can't beat her own darkness. She wanted to marry Dillian. She came to beat her own darkness and marry Dillian.
Marry Dillian. Who is Dillian?
She thought her curse would affect him. She thought her curse would spread to him.
No.
She thought she'd bring the darkness to him too. She nearly died. She thought the curse made her tainted.
No, not this way. No, yeah. You have to look at that. Okay. So there is a bridge over there. When we first came here, there is no bridge. But now there is a ladder. A small bridge. Let's go, let's go. No. Maybe I can. Go this way. My God. I did not see that first time. So we have to use this gate again. Okay. I mean, this game is so cool, bro. It's so freaking cool. Okay. Okay, so I have to go back.
The Northmen say that Odin and his brothers killed Ymir, and that the world of men was formed from his corpse. They made his bones into stone, and his flesh into earth, and his blood into the salt sea. They set his skull to be the bowl of the sky, with his brains for clouds.
Okay,
Odin and his brothers caught the sparks flying from Muspel and made them into stars. And to protect the new world from the giants, they used Ymir's great curving eyebrows as wolves.
Go back. So there is a stair over there. No. Okay, so go back. Okay. I see. My God. my god. Oh my god.
The gate is open.
Open.
There is no such thing as victory when it comes to the darkness. It's like it doesn't want to kill them. Yet.
God.
Biding its time. Only when she is at her weakest will it strike to kill. Will she find Dillion? Before her time comes.
Oh my god, finally! Oh, shoot. One more. Oh god. Maybe there is a fight here? I'm not sure.
Final illusion to face him is keeping.
Okay, so this is the final.
I know you can do it, Senua. You have the sight.
We both see the darkness. We can fight it together.
Right. There should be something here. Okay. One over there. stay the way here? Okay. Ladder. Okay.
Speak to me, Drew. Tell me a story.
Senua, listen. I will tell you the tale of a man called Findon. The Northmen captured Findon's sister, and his father sent him to pay for her release. But they took his gold, put him in chains, and held him for a day and a night without food or water. Then they released him. I don't know why. Upon his return, his father's enemies in Erin set fire to his home. His father burnt to death, and his brother was killed. But he escaped with sorrow in his heart. His father's enemies offered redress for his loss and invited him to a feast. It was at a hall near the sea. But when he went there, they betrayed him to the Northmen, who enslaved him and took him to hell. 6 years later, his slave masters landed on the shores of Orkney, burning all before them. And into that fire, Findon made his escape. What was Findon burnt away that day? But from the flames, a new man stepped forward, and Druth was born. Druth. Man that I am now. And though Findon never set eyes on his dear sister again, I, Druth, have found you, Senua.
I wish you could have seen my home before these dark times.
Okay. Kind of get down. Yeah. Let's go, boy. Fino? What? God. Be supposed to die this way? What? Again. No. God, I think I'm gonna die again. No. So we have to die here once. One thing is missing. Okay.
Ravens. Broken.
The gate is wide open.
This darkness. I know it from the wilds. It's coming back for me.
God, something behind me. My cat.
Are you still here? Are you too? Where are we? I remember. It didn't end well in the wilds. It never does. You think you can overcome the darkness, make sense of it, and once relief settles in, it strikes out of nowhere, throwing you helplessly back into the maelstrom, drowning the mind in fear, deeper, deeper, dragging you down so far into the void that maybe this time there is no coming back. There, in the darkness.
Senua.
She remembered what he told her.
Hear me. Reach out to me. Senua. Take my iron mirror. Look into it. For it is a window into the underworld. Within, you will see the face of the darkness that you fear. And if you focus, like I have taught you to, you will also see that as much as the darkness has you trapped within its veil, it too is trapped right within yours. Focus! Focus! Focus!
I see you! I see you now! You all led right me to the wilds! You all led right me there!
Hello, bitch! Hello, bitch!
Where's he going?
Oh my god.
Yeah, she's scared. No one can.
No.
Quickly get up, they're coming! Get out of the way!
Oh my god, I died once.
She can still do it.
not today, boy. No! Oh my god. I got to be careful. Bro. I got to finish one by one, bro.
Behind you.
My god. That's it, bro.
Focus.
bad tree, bro.
I never beat you in the wilds, did I? It was an illusion. But not this time!
Good job, Finu! You're freaking dead.
The mark of Valravn. One of the keys to the gate to Helheim. Hold it in your mind's eye.
With every battle, the darkness grows stronger. Every victory, bringing her closer to defeat. Unfair, isn't it? In those dark winter nights in the wilds, there were times when she considered letting go. If it weren't for Druth, a chance encounter in the wilds, she would not have heard his stories of the Northmen. And she would not have this chance to find Dillian's soul.
Yay! The door open, the gate open. Oh my god. Ooh! So, alright guys, thank you for joining me tonight. So, tonight I'm gonna end this episode right now, right here, so I'm gonna come back tomorrow again. I hope you guys liked this episode, and don't forget to hit like or subscribe or follow my page on Facebook too. And appreciate your time and appreciate your support so far. Appreciate everything. Alright guys, and thank you. I'll see you next time. Bye bye.